Sunflower, my eyes want you more than a melody. Let me inside, wish I could get to know you. Sunflower.
Hi guys, what's up? Welcome back to the channel. So this is Zach's Daily Fashion and today we're on episode 10. So today's video is actually a special request. I've had a lot of people saying and giving the thoughts that they want to have a video on my fragrances because I've got a huge collection of fragrances and aftershaves. So I'm going to talk you guys through what my daily uses are and also maybe what the odd occasional ones are that I use, some go-to scents as well and some recommendations for you guys to try out at home. Other than that, I just wanted to talk you guys through the new process I'm going to do for the channel. So we're currently peaking out nearly 300 subscribers. So what I'd like to do now is I'd like to do my fashion vlogs and videos in episodes of 10 at a time. Just allows me a little bit more time to produce the content and then you guys aren't waiting so long for videos. So I'm going to do basically seasons, a bit like a TV show. So I'm going to do 10 episodes per season. So this is episode 10 of this first season. I'll bring all the videos out and get all the content done and then I'll release them week after week so you're not waiting for more content. So I'll probably bring out the next season roughly around the 300 subscriber mark. So if we can try and push for 300 subscribers, that'd be fantastic. But anyway, let's get on with today's video.
I don't wanna make you feel bad, but I've been trying hard not to talk to you.
Right guys, so I've just poured myself a cup of coffee and without further ado, we'll talk about my fragrances. So I'm not really sure what you guys wanted from the fragrance video, but effectively I'm just going to talk you through what I like, what I use, and see what you guys think. So, first thing I want to mention is that there's three types of fragrances. So you've got eau de toilettes, you've got eau de parfums, and you've got parfums. Now, your eau de toilettes are the cheapest in the range. They're the ones that are a bit weaker, not really strong, long-lasting. Then you've got eau de parfums, which are in the middle, and your perfumes are your most expensive ones, maybe ones you wouldn't use for daily use, and they're the ones that are stronger and more intense smelling. So I'm going to start with my favourite eau de toilettes that I'd probably use daily. So the brand that we're going to talk about first is Maison Margiela. So their line of fragrances is called The Replica. They are very popular, so you've probably heard of these. If you're already watching my channel, you're into fashion, you may be into fragrances, but you might not have heard of these, so I'm going to talk you through it. So effectively, these are reproductions of familiar scents and moments, and they have varying locations and periods. So basically what they've tried to do is they've tried to reproduce different scents that sort of bring us happiness in life, which I really like. I think that's a nice idea. So my favourite one is the Coffee Break. So this is meant to be from Stockholm Coffee Shop in 2007 and it gives off creamy and cosy vibes. So basically it's just a nice coffee smell, like ground up coffee beans. If you like coffee, this is amazing. If you don't, just forget this one. But this is a really nice daily use. The only problem with the Replica fragrances are, because they are the eau de toilettes, they don't last very long. So you do want to top it up in the day if you want to keep smelling the same. I reckon about 30-40 minutes and these do wear off, so that is my only criticism with them, even though the smells are amazing. So Coffee Break's my favourite. One that I use not sort of as much as Coffee Break, even though it is pretty much empty at this moment because I've had it a lot longer, is the Jazz Club. So Jazz Club's one of the most popular scents, and that's supposed to be a jazz club from Brooklyn in 2013, and it smells of heady cocktails and cigars. And it does exactly what it says on the tin. It smells really cigar, really like, gives off really nice vibes of being in a jazz club, really nice alcoholic sort of cocktail vibes, maybe a whiskey, an old fashioned. And that's really nice for sort of using on a night. I like that one on a night or an evening. If you're going for a date or you are going for cocktails, it smells nice. The other Replica ones to mention that are my favourite, the Matcha one's really nice. There's a new one called On A Date. That's one worth mentioning. And then the other one is in Harrods at the moment. They've got an exclusive one if you get yourselves down to London. If you've not already watched my previous video, the London trip, I did go to Harrods on there and you might be able to see it in the video. But there was an exclusive fragrance called Under the Stars, I think it is. And it's really nice. It's meant to be the Namibian desert. And it's like, it's hard to explain what it smells like because how can you make a desert smell? But it really does sort of give you those starry night vibes, and it's a really nice one, but it is limited edition to Harrods, so you can only pick it up there at the moment. I'm hoping they do release it elsewhere, but at the moment that's where you've got to pick it up, so that's another one. Right, moving on from the Margiela Replica fragrances, Some other good ones to note that are eau de toilettes are the Marks and Spencer's fragrances. So these are really cheap, coming in at £10 each. They are like travel fragrances. This is what I really like about them. Because they're so cheap and because they sort of don't last that long, you can sort of top up throughout the day and just chuck one of these in your bag. So they've got three or four scents. At the moment, I've got Warmth, I've got Breathe, and I've got Ease. My favourite probably is the Warmth, and that's the most popular at the moment because it's effectively copying the sandalwood from Lilabo and Byredo's Mojave Ghost. So basically, it's got those sandalwood vibes, it's got a bit of cinnamon leaf and some cedarwood. But it is a really, really nice fragrance, that one, so I'd recommend it for the £10. These ones are really good daily use, like I said, because they're small, just chuck it in your bag and you can use them all the time. Breathe is eucalyptus, thyme and vetiver. And this one sort of gives off notes of if you go to a sauna and they fill it with the eucalyptus to sort of help your nasal and sort of, you know, when you've got cold and you're using deep heat and things on your chest and whatever. That's definitely the vibes it gives off on that one. And then the other one, which is Ease, is cypress, eucalyptus and sage. And this one's a little bit more of a fresh scent. So they're the Marks and Spencer's ones. So we've got the Margiela's, the Marks and Spencer's for daily use. They're what I use. And then moving on to some eau de perfumes that I'd recommend are the All Saints ones. So the All Saints fashion brand do their own fragrance range. This one is my favourite from them. So it's Flora Mortis. It is very florally, as it says on the tin. This one's a really nice one for summer. Probably wouldn't recommend it now going into autumn, winter. Other than the All Saints ones, I do have a few by Molton Brown, which is obviously the British fragrance company. I think most of them are unisex. This one I've got here is Geranium. So the Geranium one literally smells like geraniums, which is, you know, what it's called. And then I've got Tobacco, which I do really like the Tobacco one, but it isn't a daily use for me. I would use this probably once every couple of weeks when I'm feeling in the mood for it. You don't always want to smell like tobacco. It has to be the right setting for me to use that one. And then the other one is the Recharge Black Pepper, so that's a nice one as well. All of these ones, other than the Geranium one, I'd say these two are quite masculine, so that's what I'd recommend for those. I do like quite a few feminine fragrances as well. I like a bit of a mix in my sort of routine. Right, so moving on. I've got a few sort of high street fashion brand ones that you can sort of pick up in Boots or your normal sort of high street retailers. So the ones to mention are the Standard Prada one, which comes in this bottle. I'm not sure what the actual name of this label is, but it's a really nice fresh one. It's one that you can sort of wear at any time of year, so I recommend you giving that one a try. The other ones I've got are the Loewe Anonimo, which is quite a distinct smell. I can't really describe it, but it's very distinct, so you've got to try that one at home. And then I've got the Loewe Essentia, which is a bit more accessible. And my favourite one from just sort of your generic designers, you know, from Boots, whatever, is the Dior Homme. So I know that a lot of people use Sauvage, and I know it's got a bad rep with the whole Johnny Depp thing, but the Robert Pattinson advert one, the Dior Homme Intense, is absolutely beautiful. It's really masculine, it's really musky, and I would actually wear this as a daily use as well, and it lasts quite a while, this one. So this one's an eau de perfume as well, so we're still on the eau de perfume range there. Not too expensive, probably around the £100 mark, which I don't think is too bad for fragrances these days, considering the Tom Ford ones can hit, you know, up to £300. So that's a really good one to recommend. And now we're going to move on to my utter favourites. So these are the ones that I just pull out for the special occasions, the birthdays, Christmas. So these are, to start with, I've got the Tom Ford Fabulous, which is in such a small bottle because it really is that expensive, but it is fabulous. And then I've got Tom Ford Ombre Leather. As I said earlier, I really like my leather fragrances. This is just the body spray. I used up the fragrance, but I will rebuy the fragrance. And it really is just like sort of walking into a Louis Vuitton shop with fresh leather smell. Really nice. Lasts for hours as well, that one. I've had a lot of compliments. And to finish off, my favourite fragrance range of all time at the moment is the Celine fragrances. So if you've not already watched the London video, like I said earlier, I went to the Celine store as well and I tried on all the fragrances. So give that a watch if you want. This one is the Don Paris, which is my favourite for daily wear. Also for special occasions. You could just use this anytime. It just smells amazing. It's got hints of vanilla. It's really sweet. Probably quite feminine, but it is really, really nice. And it does give the vibes of Paris. I love Paris as a city. And this, I think, just sort of sums it up in one fragrance. Really nice. And then I love the thing about Celine. They do these travel fragrances. So you get this in either black, gold or silver. You can just take it around in your pocket or chuck it in your bag. And you get refills. I think they're about 2 refills this size, about 20ml. You get 2 of them for about £80, and you can have any fragrances, mix and match. So this one was the black tie that I was using. As you can see, I loved it. The black tie was really nice for sort of weddings, funerals, special occasions. Really smelt quite strong, that one, and quite musky and very masculine. So I recommend that one as well. But yeah, so these are really good price, and you can carry them around as well. So they're my favourites of all. Love the glass bottle as well on the big ones. So if you do go for one that you absolutely love. The only issue with these fragrances with the Celine is if you don't live in a major city, they're really hard to get a hold of, because I think you do need to smell all the fragrances. And I had to go to London to obviously try these ones. But now I've been, I absolutely love them. So a few points I'd make to you guys at home, if you're looking for a fragrance for yourself, I'd always recommend that you do try it on your skin as well. You need to make sure that it matches your body, because sometimes you can smell one in the bottle, on a card, and then you put it on your skin and it either doesn't last or it just smells horrendous. So you need to match it with your skin as well. I'd also recommend, you don't need as many as me, I'm absolutely crazy. Maybe just have one for daily use and one for evening, nighttime, just to mix it up so you don't always smell the same. But up to you guys what you want to do. Obviously, that's how I do my routine, so you've seen it now. You've seen the ones I recommend, so maybe you'll go home and you'll try some of these of yourself. But other than that, thanks for watching. Video. Thanks again for watching. I hope you've enjoyed seeing my fragrance collection. If you have any other recommendations for videos that you want to see, then please add them in the comments. At the moment, I'm currently working on the next season, so I'm going to bring out another 10 episodes. But if you can do this for me, please try and recommend the channel. Get us to 300 subscribers. Please like, subscribe, and share with your friends. Anyone who's into fashion, fragrances, try and recommend the channel, and we'll see if we can make a push to 300 before I post my next content. Thanks again for watching, guys, and take care. Let me inside. I wanna get to know you. I don't wanna make you feel bad, but I